You can be his forever baby, but tonight you're mine. He just pay your time and tell me you're mine. And money is time. You better stop, bitch. I'm on the plane, baby. I'm on it and getting it. You the baddest in this thing right now. In it right now. Right now. Right now. I just like that one part. Good everybody, make sure y'all like, share, comment, join the live right now. We finna go down the rabbit hole. We finna do it. Let's talk about it right quick. If you're not subscribed to my YouTube channel, please go do so at Knee Baby Stupid Stud. Be sure y'all be ready to check me out on the upcoming TV show talk show experiment show, Humility of Humanity, this May 2022 on Zingo TV. What's up y'all? What's good? Y'all ready for this large? Y'all ready for this? Talk about it. Y'all ready to talk about this shit? Because I want to know, do we really not care, or do we genuinely have something to say about this? Everybody know that Black Twitter has been booming and bunking lately. I am not on Twitter. I am not a Twitter fan. My page had been banned on Twitter for whatever reason. I really don't know. And it's been hard for me to get my Twitter account back. So I just gave up on that their app. But when it comes to Twitter and Instagram, we all know that the latest cases will be on the Shade Room. And the Shade Room also loves to give us every type of tea and any type of messiness and need that we need to talk about. So today's Let's Talk About It topics are going to be just a few that we have been dealing with lately and to ruffle some feathers. So the first topic we're going to talk about is the Caucasian young lady. I do not know her name. They will not let her name be known. Well, I don't know her name. I don't know if y'all know her name. And I can't pronounce the young black name. So the biracial couple that was just together, the white young lady with the black man that's been viral right now, when she was found to stab him to death. She just stabbed him to death. And everybody's been in uproar on it on Twitter, Instagram, and now TikTok. It has been brought to the TikTok family's eye. And then we're going to talk about the Miss Ketanji Brown and her lenient ways to molesters and rapists. So we're going to get into these topics today. Her name is Taylor. Thank you to Tashira Shannon. Thank you, Tashira Shannon. So what y'all feel? What are y'all inputs and comments on this black young man? I know a lot of black people said they don't give a damn, to each his own. Somebody said people don't deserve to die, but some people don't deserve sympathy, which I agreed with that when she said that. Melanated Queen said that in the comments on the video I duetted. But what are your thoughts about this? Somebody said that, you know, you die by what you live by, and he died, you know, by the hands of a white woman because he loved white women so much. So I don't know. Y'all give me some comments. Y'all give me some feedback on this story here that we're talking about it right now here today on Let's Talk About It, because, you know, it's a lot of black men out here that are dating white women and won't be as verbal as he was on Twitter. He was very verbal about how he felt about his culture, about his black race, and about black women. But you have some black men right now till this day that are dating different races, different women, preferably white women, and are not saying the real reasons why they are dating these white women, or why they're in love with these white women, or why they choose these white women. So this is an open floor discussion, an open floor topic. Now, if y'all, if I got nothing but black women on here and y'all scared to comment, then y'all just say that. If I have melanated women on here and y'all scared to talk, if I got black men on here and y'all scared to say y'all piece, just say that. Because I need some people that's not afraid to speak up and say what it is that they feel and their thoughts and their opinion. Y'all love throwing y'all comments on everything else. Y'all love commenting and replying and saying what y'all got to say about everything else. But why? What is the problem? He voiced his shit loudly. The question is, do we not give a fuck about her walking free? Regardless on what he said, it's the point that she is walking free. She pleaded insanity, and then yet she is walking scot-free. I have a lot of questions to black men, because this is not the first example. This is not the first black man who lost their life to a white woman stabbing them or killing them to death. This is not the first black man, but this is the first viral black man that said he didn't give a fuck about black women, basically, to run it down. He don't care about his black culture, basically, to run it down, and was killed by the hands of a white woman that is out here scot-free. So you leaving it to the Lord. So she's on to the next black man right now. So as black women that are mothers of these young black men, what do you have to say about this? I know his mama probably hurt. And like I said, it's black men out here that won't voice what he voiced on Twitter. Compared to how he spoke about black women, you have black men that are afraid to say that, but still would date white women. It's black men out here that will be all for their culture, all for their culture. Black lives matter out here but won't date a black woman. I feel a lot of ways about that. You know, it's a lot of black men that is for the culture, but has a white woman. You know what I'm saying? It's a lot of that. You know what I'm saying? But it's just, that's between him and God, but she should go to jail. Exactly. And this is my thing. Do any of y'all know the case about the Isabella Guzman? If y'all not ready for this talk show that I'm on, we talked about the Isabella Guzman case. If y'all aren't familiar with the Isabella Guzman case and the Nico Jenkins case, how is it that this Caucasian woman is able to plead sanity and walk scot-free, but Isabella Guzman is in a mental facility? She got 31 years in a mental facility. Nico Jenkins told the judge that he was mental and he was going through something. Do not let him out in the streets. They let him out in the streets and he ended up murdering 3 more people in Omaha, Nebraska. If y'all want to talk about it, that's privilege. That is privilege. That is a privileged serial killer. Because what she's going to do is she's probably going to do it again. And then again, and then again. She's not, that's my thing. We don't care about him, but what about her? Should she be held accountable? They are allowed to plead insanity and get a slap on the hand and let go. She needs to be held accountable and prosecuted as a crime. A crime is a crime. A crime is a crime. That's why that lets you know the system is messed up. And I know we don't care about that, but I would like to ruffle some feathers for a bit sec. For all my melanated women, all my black women, if you are a black woman, please come to this live. If you are a black woman, please stay in this live. I have one question to you. Knowing that Ms. Ketanji Brown is more lenient on child molesters, rapists, and pedophiles, how do you feel about that? How do you feel about that? I'm ready to read this shit. Everybody's so, y'all be so hyped about when a black person become in office and when a black person is ready to run and when a black, oh, they're giving us all reason to know that we can do this and we can do that. We're looking up to them. We're doing this. But what about the backstories of these people? It's unacceptable, but yet we praise her. We've been praising her. I feel her record is comparable to white judges. White judges have done worse. Of course, they are more lenient on murderers. That's why they picked her. She's a do girl. I said, ooh, I don't like it. And that's why I don't get on the hype of color alone. You can't, human race. I honestly didn't know that. That's wild. She knew what she had to do. She knew what she had to do and she did what she had to do. You know what I'm saying? Kamala Harris. Y'all love y'all some Kamala Harris, right? Y'all love Kamala. Love Kamala. but she has incarcerated more black men and kept them incarcerated for wrongful crimes. Yes. Some of them for misdemeanors and minor crimes. Selling weed, cocaine, crack in the 80s. What they had to do to survive. What not had, ain't had not name charge or prior before that, but possession. She had them doing time life for possession. But y'all love these type of people. Y'all be like, yeah, yeah. Not Kamala. I always thought she was a joke. But it's politics. It's politics. We look at it and the first thing we see is the color of their skin. Black people, black people, black people. They doing it. Doing it. They doing it. They doing it. They doing it. Yeah, black people, black people. But you don't understand what these people done did. And this goes for, and it's not even for the black people. It's for the whites as well. But this let us know that black people don't really do their homework and don't know what's really going on in the situation. The first thing we our little silly tail selves do is think, oh, they black. But have you done your research? Do you know, you know what I'm saying? I know I'm scratching the surface. I know it. I know it. I should stop, huh? They doing it just not for us. It's pimping. Knowledge is power and a lot of ignorance to the black stories. Big facts. I learned that. We got our research even when they exactly dispensaries on every corner. Now I'm just saying it's I want to be able to openly talk about this, but we are afraid to talk about it. Why? Why are we so afraid to speak on it? Why are we so afraid to speak on it? Like I said in my live earlier, I don't vote. I don't give a fuck about the legislative, the judicial, the whatever branch y'all got going, the Republicans, Democrats, the Republic, all that. I don't get into all that, because if you're not starting and doing your research at the bottom, why in the fuck is y'all worrying about who up top? Because y'all not paying attention to the lawyers and the chief of polices and the mayors and the governors that y'all are voting in the office. But the first time a president get running in this bitch, y'all running to go vote for fucking president. But what about the council people and the Senate people that y'all put in house? Y'all not talking about that. Y'all not doing y'all research about that. I'm almost 40 and realized a few years ago how brainwashed I was in educating myself. Like we spoke on the previous live earlier today, they put it in the books because they know one goddamn thing. A black person is not going to pick up a book and read it. They want a preacher to tell it to them. They want the mayor to tell it to them. They want the black man to get them through them. They want somebody to tell them how it is. Preach, preacher, you speaking. Besides picking up a book and reading, besides going to the corner store and getting a newspaper, besides doing your homework and doing your research on what's going on really in the world today. We don't know because we off. The military and the government is trying to control everything. They trying to get things in control. They trying to have this, the big territory ran by them. And our stupid asses is sitting here worrying about Fashion Nova. Our stupid asses is worried about getting $100,000 in our bank account. Our stupid asses is worried about having these big ass gold chains that can barely fit our motherfucking neck. But we still got that bitch on covering our whole motherfucking chest when there's people outside in Los Angeles that's living under a fucking bridge. You got homeless people everywhere you go. But when you pass them, you won't give them a $20. You won't give them any loose chains that you got in your car. Y'all don't want to speak about it. You get hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of dollars of your food stamps, but you don't think about creating, making sandwiches and plates to give away to homeless people that is in your area, because we're not thinking like that. We're not doing things in love and light. We're not on that page. We're out here for selfish gain. Everyone is out here for selfish gain. Everyone needs a dollar. When they say money is the root of all evil, because it is. If we don't have money, we don't survive. If we don't have money, we can't pay our bills. If we don't have money, then we are homeless. So why is it the ones with money that's working these hard 9-to-5s that has money in their savings account and checking account, when they see somebody, they frown upon them
besides blessing them. The first thing we say is, oh, they made their life how they wanted. Oh, they must have did crack. Oh, they must have. You come up with every fucking thing on why you shouldn't. You give yourself excuses on why you shouldn't bless somebody else. Distraction, delusion, and deception equals division. I love that. Let me make sure I'm following you. I love it. I love it. It's deeper than what we know and what we think. If we're not out here being a vigilant, if I need sugar, I got 58 people on here right now. I said, y'all, I don't have no gas in my car. I'm trying to make it to upstate New York so I can do my mom's burial, which all of you had paid for the April 23rd virtual comedy show with your $5. And all that money that we raised is going to my mom's burial, and I'm redoing it. If y'all can just help me get some gas money. The people who has faith in that person to do what that person said they're going to do is going to send money to that Cash App for that person to get gas, for that person to get to where they have to go. Anybody else that don't believe in that person, first thing they're going to say is, oh, you on here begging for money? You need to get a job. Why every time I get on social media, people are always dropping their Cash App? Why every time I get on social media, we have to pay for somebody to get a room? We have to pay for... Either you're going to be in love and light and have faith in that person to help that person, to love that person enough to help that person, or you're going to be jealous, hateful, envious, and go talk behind that person back. Girl, I just got off live. These people that be on TikTok do too much. I don't see why they won't get a job. Besides understanding... and understanding what love and help really is. Some of us are sitting here single parents and don't have a proper babysitter because it's money. It's money. But we have siblings. But we have best friends. But we have aunts and uncles and grandparents that we don't love and we don't pay attention to. So therefore, it's toxic families. And therefore, when your family wants to watch your kid, you don't trust it because you don't know if that child's going to be molested. When your family want to watch your kid, it's money involved. And if you don't got no money, they're not going to help you. We need to go back to the basics. What happened to help and love? I love my sister and I help her freely. I love anyone around me and I help them freely. We don't know nothing about that shit. It's all about the dollar. Grandparents, you charging your child $100 a week to watch your grandbaby when that grandbaby has nowhere else to go because you got money. You working a 9-to-5. You still getting extra money to buy what? Cigarettes and beer? To go to bingo? Your grandchild has a price tag on his head. Your baby is a money. Your baby is a $20 bill, a $100 bill, an EBT card. It's what you can do for somebody. We're not out here willingly trying to love each other, and we're not out here willingly trying to help each other. So, yes, the first thing we do is we frown upon anyone homeless. We don't bother to help them. We don't bother to look for loose change, the dollars we have in our car. When our friends are struggling and they need help with their kids, and this is another thing, people, women who deal with depression and stress are single parents. You know how many suicides come from single mothers? I'll wait. Do you know the number and the percentage of how many suicides come from single mothers? I will wait. Because they have no help with their children, I will wait. And then their children get put in the system because the family is not there to help them. I will wait. But your best friend who ain't got no kids in the club every Saturday and Friday, mimosas on Sunday, she can't help you. She won't bother to get TT baby. Your sister got kids and the kids are well taken care of and your kid can't get dropped off over there for a couple hours while you go make a check. That's sad. TT baby. You can't trust your children around their uncles because you are afraid of them being molested and touched and harmed. TT baby. You are in these relationships with these men who don't give a fuck about you, so they harm your child. And then you end up with them in jail. Y'all know how many parents are in jail right now? Single mothers that's with these boyfriends because these boyfriends decided to harm their child and the baby ended up dead. Come on, let's talk about it. Y'all don't want to talk about what's real. Miss, I can't be alone. Got so-and-so in the house with another baby dead, unconscious, not breathing. What happened? He don't know. He was asleep. He took a nap. So many stories that sound the same. And you know what's crazy about? You also have to watch which friends and family you help, unfortunately. You know what's crazy about that? That's toxic. Because I don't never have to watch my friends that I help. I don't never have to watch my family that I help. I don't never have to watch anybody that I associate with that I help. Because I'm not looking over my shoulder after I help them. I'm not questioning if my help was sincere after I helped them. Yeah, they will take advantage, but that lets you know where you stand. That lets you know where you stand. You allow people to take advantage of you. Some motherfuckers don't have a problem with saying no. I don't. Y'all feel like y'all have to. You don't. The system doesn't exist without ignorance. Everybody is ignorant. That's why I say ignorance is bliss. Everybody got it. Everybody got it. Shit, you're not obligated to do anything for anybody. That's why I said operating in love and wanting and willing to help someone is not, it's different. That's no toxic involved. Everything is not toxic. You know, that's what I don't like about people. Everything ain't got to be toxic. Friends don't have to be toxic. Family don't have to be toxic. Everything ain't got to be a toxic situation. Everybody don't have to think negative. Everybody don't have to take advantage of something. You know what I'm saying? Everybody don't have to look for something out of something. Everybody, you know, that's the problem with what's going on. It's a lot of problems what was going on, but I don't like people like that. You know what I'm saying? I can't get jiggy with people like that. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, there's no obligation when love is involved. Never. Yeah, they're not genuine, God. That's the least of our worries. I think we worry about the things that we have no control over. A lot of us humans worry about things we have no control over. We worry about the next person. We have no control over the next person. We worry about it, though. We worry about it badly and deeply, but we have no control about that. You have no control. You say what you say your piece, you do what you gotta do, keep going. But what I no longer have room for is toxic people, toxic energy, negative folks, and people who can't think clear and give a different perspective of things. Everything ain't got to be black and white. Hey, everything ain't got to be black and white. You know what I'm saying? It's color in this shit. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, if you go have justice being served, I feel like Taylor, the young lady that just stabbed the black man up till he died, I feel like she should have been in jail, or if she's pleading insanity, she needs to be in some mental facility. And I stand on that. Not from the black dude. Like the one young lady said, people don't deserve to die, but a lot of people do not deserve sympathy. We be giving these gangsters all our sympathy. You know what I'm saying? When they live in that street life and they done caught a few bodies, we might not know the bodies that they done caught, but we be, as soon as they go to jail, free such and such. Soon as they die, RIP, sleep in peace, da-da-da, such and such. But they done killed so many people. They done harmed so many families. They done did, you know, so many things wrong, but we be steady hollering. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's a whole lot, and I don't want y'all to ever feel like, yeah, I hate to see free soil. Like, come on now. Let's talk about the things. You know what I'm saying? Like, black people don't know to invest in life insurance. Black people, and I ain't gonna say black people, the human race don't know to invest in life insurance. I say invest in life insurance because that is the rich man's investment. Life insurance is the wealthy man's investment. If you're not investing in life insurance, then what you're doing? You're focusing on your credit as well as what you're doing. Everybody who still has student loan debt, every time, which is crazy, every time you pay off something that's student loan, it goes on your credit. So continue to pay your small payments on your student loans. As much as you don't, as much as they're going to try to take from you and keep it away from you by harming your credit. You know what I'm saying? Let's be smarter. Let's read more. Let's read more. Let's research more. Let's look into what's going on in the world. Stop being dumbfounded. You know what I'm saying? And I do need gas money. And that's my Cash App down there. So if any one of y'all got $5, make sure y'all bless the Cash App, because I got to make it to upstate New York to my sister's house, because my mama is buried in upstate New York right now. And I'm doing her burial when I get there before her birthday, because her headstone will be placed now that the ground is softening. It's not snowing anymore upstate. So I have to go check on everything for my mom and make sure my mom
mom is straight. I do work for myself, so don't worry about it. I just have nothing for sale besides my Sprinkles and Rainbows members only t-shirt. That's all I got. I ain't got nothing for sale. I sold out all my DVDs. I got my comedy show April 23rd. I got the comedy show in Dallas, Texas, June 18th. So if you in Dallas, Texas, and y'all want to see a stand-up comedy show, make sure y'all come check out me, Callie, and Dizzy underscore Christmas, June 18th, and Fever at the Fevermatic Studios in Dallas, Texas, June 18th weekend. So if y'all want to see that, oh, and make sure y'all go to Aries Essentials and go get y'all some CBD gummies. It really had me calm in like 20 minutes. I had popped like three of these bitches, chewed about three of them bitches up, you know what I'm saying? And I just was feeling brand new. Anything you feeling brand new. Coming June 18th, I'm in Fort Worth. Well, get your ticket. So we only got 43 tickets left right now for the comedy show, period. So it's only 43 tickets left. So if you are in the Dallas area, surrounding areas, and you can get to the comedy show, it's at the Fevermatic Studios. Make sure you go, hurry up, hustle up, and grab your tickets ASAP. Do not miss out on that. It is June 18th. It is on a Saturday. Aw, thank you for the love and light, understanding, and your mother. Thank you. I appreciate that. You know, I'm transparent. I'm very clear. You know what I'm saying? Ask for what you ask for. My mama said, ask for what you need and what you want. Closed mouths don't get fed. So, you know, somebody might want to bless me. You know what I'm saying? I'm not broke. I'm sick. You know what I'm saying? So when you sick is that I have money set aside only for my mother. And I refuse. I love it. I refuse to use the money that I have for my mother on myself and for my personal needs. You know, I just did the filming for the TV show that I was on. So I wasn't able to fully, like, you know, make shirts, do stuff. And I said I was done with that shit anyway. Making clothes and having a clothing line is so hard when your mama just passed and all your money done went to your mama, all, you know, her burial and, you know, casket and clothes and all this shit y'all done helped me gather up and conjure up. It just been so much. So, you know, I'm back at square one. So with being back at square one, it's a good thing. You know, I'm not in a bad place. Like I said, my bills are handled. My wife helps everything out when it comes to me on the back end, you know what I'm saying? But I'm not out here, you know, just allowing my wife to handle everything. And I don't be out here asking my sister for handouts. Somebody had laughed and was like, why don't you ask your sister for some gas money? My sister has four children, 19, 14, 7, and 6. And I would definitely not ever take anything out of my sister's pockets. I would make it on my own. I would ask y'all before I ask my sister. And I would get it up and I would go do what I gotta do. Where we get the gummies? So go to Aries Essentials on TikTok and Instagram. Aries, like the zodiac sign Aries. Aries Essentials. Aries Essentials on Instagram or TikTok, and go order. You can get the gummy bears or you can get the watermelons. They're 500 mg, but they're 10 mg a piece. Okay, so they work instantly. They work pretty instantly. It had me, you know, I'm a hyperactive person, so it hit me with that, you know what I'm saying? I calmed down real quick. I was like, oh shit, you know what I'm saying? I was like, oh shit, you know, I hit that oh shit. Sorry for your loss of your mother. Oh, no, it's fine. It is okay. It is okay. It is okay. My mother's in a better dimension than we are in. You know what I'm saying? She was already dealing with a lot of complications. We did not expect it. It was unexpected, like we say all the time. But although she's not here in the flesh, she is still here in the spirit. Especially around my house, she does what she wants here. I gotta go upgrade on her candles and stuff like that, because her candles go out quick. So her 7-day, 5-day candles do not ever last 7 or 5 days. I be like, she just be walking all over the place and be going too many places. I be telling her she be traveling too much, because when you travel too much in the spiritual realm with your candle, they get, you know what I'm saying? They go out quicker. You know what I'm saying? Like, they really go out quicker. And I be telling her, like, baby, slow down, pipe down. Like, you be going to see all these different people. Like, stay where you're supposed to be. But she just be all over the place. So I just let her do what she do. You know, she's a famous lady. You know, everybody love them some Mama Val. If y'all not following her TikTok, make sure y'all follow her TikTok. Cause she love it. She love it. She needs more of it. I know I be trying to keep her TikTok page alive and going and shit, so she know. But I'm gonna click off this live and I'm gonna just join back on a regular live. So I thank y'all for joining. Let's talk about it. If you missed the whole Let's Talk About It, you can also catch the recap live on my YouTube channel at Knee Baby Stupid Stud. So if you're not subscribed to Knee Baby Stupid Stud YouTube channel, please go do so. I thank y'all. I love y'all. Thank y'all for joining. Let's talk about it. Thank y'all for being open and honest in the comments. Until next time.